heard the law is trying to start meddling in these parts.
Well, hell, you know what I'm saying?
Everything's so swirly.
Yeah.
Mister, first time?
You always come out looking like that?
So?
Just give me a drink, quick.
Enjoy. You want another?
Howdy, partner. Is that the latest fashion? I'm guessing not.
Hey, y'all.
Hello, mister.
Hello, lover.
Mister. Howdy.
Mister.
What's been happening around here? Eat up. Good, huh?
Hey, watch your step.
Forgiveness for a price. Seems like we can't go a week without another dead body drifting to shore here.
Thanks, partner.
Crossroads, where you've been, I once was standing tall, now I feel my back against the wall, stand and shake amid a mist of crash. Yeah. could not see. And I don't wonder, as a wayward soul, was a haunt to be haunted by the smoking gun.
Anybody here? Hello? Anyone here? Susan, Strauss, you here? Hello?
Dear Uncle Tacitus, I do so hope you enjoyed your vacation. Lucky you. Leaving like that. And you always suggested you were too old for travel. I hope you and your cousins enjoyed yourselves. Me and your grandnieces have decided to take a trip of our own, as the place has become so dreary and godforsaken in your absence. We have gone to visit relatives. From my daddy's side, you are not yet acquainted with them, in Lacay, a small village just north of Saint Denis. It's buggy and muggy. But apparently neither is too bad at this time of year. Please, come see us when you can. Yours sincerely, Caroline.
Well, thank you, darling niece Caroline. I guess I'm coming to see you in Lacay.
Milton keeps sending us back every day to search this place.
There quite clearly isn't a gang of outlaws held up here.
Someone is here. Look, those are fresh footprints. Looks like someone might be here right now.
Sure, someone is here. There's always someone everywhere.
Well, let's look around then. See if we can find something for Mr. Milton.
Mr. Milton? I'd like to find a poisonous snake for him.
That's enough, Mr. Johns. You take Mr. Bunter and search around back.
Mr. Orley, let's head inside. Gentlemen, be careful.
Arthur's here!
Oh, Arthur! Oh, you're laughing!
Just about.
Come inside. Come on, it's raining. Hey, everybody, look who's here.
Hey, y'all doing? Hey, old man, wake up.
Hey, Arthur, they got John.
Good to see you.
Yeah, he got arrested.
He ain't hung yet?
Not yet. They moved him to Sissica. He's been working on a chain gang.
Howdy.
Oh, look.
Yes, they got John.
Okay, okay.
Hey!
How did you folks find each other? What happened? Can somebody get me a cup of coffee or something?
Boss, Mrs. Adler, who saved us, Dutch? After the robbery in Saint-Denis, she got us away from the camp before the Pinkertons turned up. Then Mrs. Adler and Mr. Smith drove away the degenerates of her living here.
Mrs. Adler? We owe you.
Yes.
Thank you.
It's been real hard, Dutch. We've been surviving, but only just. What we gonna do?
Things have been tough. There ain't no doubt about that. Trust me. I am gonna get us out of here. This ain't over.
Ain't none of you folks interested in our adventures?
Guess we're more interested in escaping the hangman on our tail?
Cheerful nymph of the prairie, wasn't you, Abigail?
Oh, sure. My fair heart jumps for joy when I set eyes on you, Micah.
We buried Hosea, Dutch. Charles and I stole his body from the law one night and gave him a proper burial. It was real nice. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Well, here you is. Well, I asked everyone I could find, and eventually someone knew, said you fools were out here. Shit. Give me a drink or something.
Get your own damn drink.
In our absence, Mrs. Adler here has been looking after things. Now sit down.
This is Agent Milton with the Pink
Agency.
Already?
On behalf of Cornwall Kerosene and Tar, the United States government, and the Commonwealth of West Elizabeth.
Here we go.
We are here to arrest you. Come out with your hands up.
Give them to a count of five, then give them everything. Actually,
let them have it.
Everyone, get down!
Asked everyone you could find, did you, Bill?
We need to push it back!
Okay, let's go!
Stop!
saved us, Arthur.
Oh, me and Bill and Sadie.
You okay, son?
Sure.
We ain't been back for more than a few days.
What do we do, Dutch?
Clearly, we need to leave. It'll take them some time to regroup. Mr. Pearson, Miss Grimshaw, start packing up. Javier, you and Bill, get out of here. Go scare off any scum still loitering about. We need a couple of days. Now, please, gentlemen.
Sure. What next, Dutch?
We just need some time. I need some time. Now, we can't go east, because then we'll be in the ocean, so we're gonna have to go north, I guess. I just need somebody to buy me some goddamn time, one of you.
You'll figure it out, boss. You always do.
What are you gonna do about John, Dutch?
John?
He's in jail.
We'll get him. Abigail, just not yet.
There's talk of hanging him.
It's not gonna come to that.
Dutch!
Not now, Mesa. Not now.
I'm begging you two. They're gonna hang him and break my... the boy's heart. Please, do something.
We will. Okay. I'm gonna go figure out how we rescue this bastard. Yes, now. Give me a Doyle's Tavern on Million Avenue.
Okay. My lord, what a goddamn mess. Everything. Not sure what happens next. Whole thing has been hard on all of us. Most of all on Dutch, who seems half crazed by all we've gone through.
You've done good, girl.
Mr. Pearson! How you coming along there?
I'm moving as fast another as possible.
Day. Well, good! All of you! Hurry this along! We need to go! Do you want those men to come back and murder us once and for all? No? Then hurry up! We need to get moving again! Quick! All of you!
Another morning.
Some reunion, huh?
Well, at least you're alive. So what now?
We got a couple of days to work that out. Good to see you again, Mr. Strauss.
But under what circumstances?
I know. Long day ahead.
Things to do this morning.
Reverend, it's good to see you again.
You too. But this is a mess. A real mess.
I know. Okay, then, girl. Yep.
Well, that beard sure looks ready for a trim. Got an idea of what you want? Looking sharper than a tack.
That's, looks pretty good. Thank you. Looks okay.
All right, you're ready to go.
Thank you for your help.
Hello.
Let's go, girl.
Hola, señor.
broccoli!
This land of equality is a sham and a disgrace.
How's things with you?
Hello, come on in.
Now, let's have a look.
There are a few colors you can go with for this one. That is one of my favorites. People around here come in just for those. You're going to love the way you look in those. What color speaks to you? Are you feeling good? Because you're looking great. Come now, don't doubt yourself. That looks excellent on you. Now that goes with just about any outfit. Now, what is your preferred color for this?
Let me vote.
You'll be getting a little more attention from the fairer sex wearing that.
Come on, people. Let me vote.
What color speaks to you?
The land of equality is a sham and a disgrace.
Are you looking for something to go with what you just bought?
Hello, ma'am.
Monsieur.
Je vous salue.
Hello, sir. Hey, mister.
Hello?
Mister, are you okay? Mister, are you okay? Are you okay, Mister? Mister, you don't look so good. Let's get you to a doctor. You head in there, friend. Go on.
Can I help you?
Doc, I need a doctor.
Oh, just one second, sir.
Come in, pal. Come in.
I need some help.
And so it seems. And that's Dr. Mister to you.
I'm sorry.
I was joking. Look, friend, I don't mean nothing, but you got money? I mean, before I start treating you. Because I got a family.
Yeah, I understand. Here, will that do
you? Sure. Thank you. Now, what's wrong? I mean, what appear to be the symptoms?
Well, I think you've heard them. I'm coughing.
Is there any blood?
Sometimes.
Uh-huh. Okay, now here. Breathe. Again? Yeah. Let me see your tongue. Say ah.
Ah. What is it?
It's not good news.
Well, I guess that.
You got tuberculosis. I'm really sorry for you, son. It's a hell of a thing.
What do you mean?
You're real sick. It's a progressive disease. And you'll be... Now, the best thing is rest. And getting somewhere warm and dry and taking it easy. Now, is that possible?
Sure, I can just take my winters in my country club in California. No, it's not possible.
Well, like I said, I'm real sorry.
Yeah, well.
Now, wait. Let me get you a little bit more energy today.
Any problems coming in?
Nah.
Guess they know now we ain't in the city.
Who, Mr. Milton's friends?
Yeah, they've had patrols out ever since you boys disappeared. Well, at least you're alive.
For now, yeah.
What happened in,
Guarma?
Yeah.
Nothing nice.
What happened to Dutch? Because he seems...
I don't know. Seems as... What began happening in Blackwater began happening years ago, maybe. A slow decline, I guess.
What do you mean?
I ain't quite sure. What happened here?
I started gathering people up as best I could after you boys left. And John, you know that part.
I do.
And Hosea?
So that too.
Hell, we got Lenny's body out as well. Bribed the morgue and buried them together. Follow me.
So, what's your plan here?
Well, I figure before we do anything, we need to make sure John's even still at this prison.
And how do we do that?
We need to get up high enough to get a proper look at the place.
What? It's on an island, ain't it? Unless you're planning on learning how to fly.
That's exactly what we're gonna do. I found us a hot air balloon.
You ain't serious.
Now, the pilot, or whatever you call him, he thinks we're just in it for a lesson. Bit of a tour. He's quite the character. I think you'll like him.
You know, I'm impressed. You really stepped things up, ain't you?
Hey, we didn't know if you was even coming back. Whole thing hit folks real hard. You can see it. Karen's gone falling fully into the bottle. Strauss is a bag of nerves. Swanson's actually gone and cleaned up his act. So I guess it ain't all gone to shit. I'm just happy you boys were able to find us. Javier said he got the letter I left at the post office.
That was a good idea.
Until the Pinkertons showed up. Oh, by the way, I've been hunting O'Driscoll boys. Killed two of the sons of bitches at a campsite last week.
What?
Yeah, seems they've drifted down this way now.
You're a busy woman, Sadie Adler.
She a beauty, ain't she?
From here on the ground, yes.
Mr. Bullard? Mr. Bullard?
Ah, Mrs. Adler! It's good to see you! Good to see you!
This is my friend I told you about, Mr. Morgan.
Ah, yes, Arturo Bullard. At your service, sir. At your service.
Arthur Morgan.
Well, it's a nice, fresh day for flying, sir. A day like today, an Icarus would have made it across the sea. Ha ha ha. Have you ever flown before, sir?
No.
Oh, it's quite a thing. Quite a thing. Now, put these on and hop in.
Well, ain't she coming?
Well, women can't fly, sir. Are you insane?
They can't.
Oh, no, sir. It does terrible damage to them, to their vapors. I thought everyone knew about that. Why, a delicate flower like Mrs. Adler? Heavens above! Or below. Ah.
Where'd you find this guy?
I told you two would get on.
Are you sure about this?
Certain, sir. Quite certain. Mrs., let us away. Wish us luck. I've only crashed twice. Now, pull on that rope and hope for the best.
You boys have fun.
How did you get out of this?
Okay, here goes nothing. Right, time to catch a few vapors of our own. It's a little overcast, but I'm expecting some good wind once we're high enough. We should still have some decent views over the river. Now, one hates to be coarse, but on the subject of ablutions, liquids over the side, solids, do your utmost to levy the situation until we land.
Okay, Mr. Bullard.
I had a client once who fell foul to a rotten oyster on the ascent. Decidedly harrowing experience for all involved. Keep going, sir! We need to get up above the clouds. It really is stunning up there. You'll have seen nothing like it. All right, then, let's break through these clouds. Remarkable, isn't it? Feels like we have a nice westerly wind, so keep her around this height. This particular vessel is state-of-the-art, sir. Imported from Europe. Won't find more than a couple of these on this side of the pond.
So long as it works. You sure you shouldn't be doing this?
Not at all. A child could operate this with a little supervision. Besides, Mrs. Adler told me you were very keen to learn the ropes. We have plenty of those.
She did, didn't she?
Okay, we're getting a little high now. My mother. father was a keen student of the Italianate. My brother's called Baldessario, so you could say I got off lightly.
Look, I'm trying to concentrate here.
Maybe ease off the throttle there, sir. In the city this morning, Mr. Morgan?
Not exactly.
Well, I have a boiled egg in my pocket here that you're very welcome to.
I think I'm all right. Thank you. Recalling the ablutions discussion.
Well, just say the word. So, if I may ask, what got you interested in the pursuit of aviation?
I didn't, exactly. Mrs. Adler thought she'd surprise me.
Ah, a very nice woman. And no shrinking violet.
Definitely not.
I prefer slightly more feminine attire on a lady, but variety is the very spice of life, as they say. Or is it, though? Did you know they locked up the man who wrote that in a mental asylum?
I did not, Mr. Bullard.
See that building up ahead on the island? That's the infamous Sisica Penitentiary. We shouldn't fly too near to it, though, sir.
Sorry, we're going in for a closer look.
What do you mean? Mr. Morgan, please, this is most irregular.
Well, you want a happy customer, don't you?
Look, this isn't funny now. What on earth are you doing? The guards are bound to spot us.
Calm down. They won't care if we stay high enough. I'm just looking for a friend of mine.
A friend?
Poor bastard has a habit of being in the wrong place at the wrong time. I heard they got him working the fields in a chain gang.
Dear God. Well, this is most unusual.
Relax, Mr. Bullard. Here, take over. Keep us well away.
I'll do my best. This filly is to control, you know. Please hurry.
That ain't John. Best try another spot.
I can't believe we're doing this.
Nope, not there. Looks like him. It's hard to tell, though. Yep, that's him.
Ah! My God!
What are you doing?
You're shooting at us!
I can see that.
Ascend! Ascend! Say, the specifics of this job are not described to me at all sufficiently.
Well, it's done now.
as Annisburg.
Sure.
Good Lord, is that Mrs. Adler?
Where?
Being chased.
Yes. Try and get us near.
Will there be more trouble, sir?
I expect so.
I'm starting to rather enjoy this.
Hey, Satan! Up there!
Us. Get behind something. This ain't over yet. These goddamn old crystals!
You can't leave us for one day!
Just kill these sons of bitches!
Thank you.
can't stay out of trouble for one goddamn hour. You got that poor bastard killed for his troubles. I kind of liked him.
They got Combe, the government. They got Combe O'Driscoll. They're gonna hang him in Saint-Denis.
Hang him? Okay.
Mm-mm. He's already been tried twice for murder and found guilty.
Sure, no doubt he'll escape again.
No, he won't, because we're gonna make sure of it.
We have our own problems with the law, in case you ain't noticed.
Dutch will want to see him swing.
Sure, Dutch. He wouldn't even help us with Marston. And our situation is really messed up right now. You know how things is.
Bastard's gonna swing. I'm gonna make sure of it.
Closely followed by Marston!
You saw him?
Yes, in the fields.
Okay. Then we go rescue him.
From a state penitentiary?
No. But from the fields? Yes. That we can manage.
It's well guarded.
Guarded, sure, but not behind bars.
No, it's not behind bars.
So, that's how we'll do it. Bust him from his work detail.
Yes.
It's best just the two of us go.
The two of us is all there is, anyhow.
Good, because two is all we'll need. I'll get us a boat, a little one, and we'll sneak in and get him out of there. Meet me at Copperhead Landing. Thank you, Arthur.
Whatever you say, boss.
I heard that.
Whoa, okay.